Gordon, there are a huge number of CRMs out there, and costs can vary hugely. What are the top things to consider in shortlisting and then working out the investment that I really need in my business?
I think there's perhaps four things that any sales or marketing lead or a managing director of a business should consider. The first is, do you actually want to put the customer at the center of your business? Now, I'm not being silly, maybe you don't, but if you do want to put the customer at the center of your business, then you will want the insights that help you attract new prospects, engage with anyone who shows interest, and delight your existing customers. So putting the customer first means that sales and marketing both have the same customer data set and use the same customer intel, which is provided to drive demand. So first thing, if they want to put customer first at the center of their business, that's one area. The second area is ask yourself the question, do you want the ability to track and measure marketing and sales efforts? If you do want that ability to measure and track that, then I think you should try and look for a CRM that can help you better understand what's working and what's not. Things like, you know, the sources of your web traffic, how well is your social, your EDM, your content are converting, how many new leads have been delivered, what is the value of your sales pipeline, and how well are your sales team performing, and so many more things. So my advice is think about the metrics that you want to measure and make sure that the CRM that you're looking at can actually deliver them. The third thing that they should consider is, are you prepared to commit the time and resources to making your CRM work for your business? I kind of liken it to, you know, you could pay a big name celebrity to front your brand, but it's great having Michael Jordan to front your brand, but then you've got to allow at least an equal amount to activate them, to make them work. And it's the same with your CRM. You've got to not just put it in, but you've got to train them on how to use the software. You should really have them audited. What are they doing well? What are they not so doing well? What are the tools they could be using better to convert? It's not a set and forget investment if you want to get the most out of it. And the fourth thing I think they should consider is consider integrations. The last thing that any business probably needs today is another piece of software to manage. So try to ensure that the CRM that you're considering can integrate with other business critical applications. Now, it might be your ERP system or your accounting software, your project management software. And if it does, that will mean that the CRM will be used effectively, and ideally, it will also contribute a whole lot less complexity to your operation and not more.